Let's get the assessment of San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora on how the modified enhanced community quarantine in Metro Manila is going so far. Welcome to the program, Mayor Zamora.
Yes, good morning, Christian, and to everyone watching AMC.
Okay, first of all, of course, we know that this should be a concerted effort among the mayors in Metro Manila and the nearby regions or provinces. But in your case, based on the experience of San Juan, would you prefer that the MECQ in Metro Manila be extended or somehow be lifted after August 18?
Christian, before I answer the question, just allow me to share first our data ever since the reimposition of MECQ started. In fact, yes, we experienced a drop in the daily number of positive cases. However, in the past few days, it went up again. And if you remember, about 2 days ago, we reached a total of close to 7,000 positive cases in 1 day. So that also reflected in our city. In fact, we reached 67 positive patients positive on that day 2 days ago. So honestly, it's really very hard to tell at this point because the MECQ has only been in effect for, I believe, 8 days. And what we experienced before when we were under ECQ and then transitioned to MECQ is we were able to sustain the very low number of positive patients. But this time around, we're doing the reverse. We are coming from GCQ going to MECQ. And it's harder now because you're coming from a very high number already. So personally, I would want to see first the next few days if indeed the numbers would go down because what we were hoping for was really a drop in the numbers. We achieved it for a few days, but then in the past few days, it went up again. So the numbers are still very volatile at this point.
Of course, Malacanang also said that it was unlikely that the MECQ would be extended after August 18. But in this case, what are the things that your local government is doing to make sure that San Juan would be ready in case we transition again from MECQ to a GCQ?
Yes, well, what we've done this past week is we released another wave of food packs to our constituents. In fact, this is our 13th wave already, ever since the community quarantine was imposed last March. So we are currently distributing our 13th wave of food packs for our constituents. At the same time, we have been constantly increasing our testing capacity and contact tracing. In fact, we have four facilities for positive patients. These are the San Juan Medical Center, the Kalinga Center, San Juan National High School Annex, and the hotel that the national government has allocated for us. So we have a total of about 300 beds for all of these combined for positive patients. And starting today also, we are doing our own mass testing here in San Juan. We will be averaging about 500 to 700 tests a day because prior to today, our mega swabbing area was in the Palacio de Maynila as assigned to us by the national government. Mm-hmm. But with the visit of the IATF last Saturday here in San Juan, they have already delegated the mega swabbing to us locally. So we are already doing this. But whatever the status will be in the next few days, of course, we will respect the decision of the IATF and of the president, whether it's MECQ or back to GCQ. San Juan will be ready. In fact, this is really a balance between the economy and the health and safety of our people. And people will really just have to follow all the minimum health standards. It's really about discipline and understanding what it takes for people not to get infected.
Okay, so far, how many positive cases or active cases does San Juan have? And you mentioned a 300 bed capacity for all those facilities combined. Would that capacity be enough in case of a surge in cases once we lift the modified enhanced community quarantine and move into a general community quarantine?
Yes, yesterday, our active cases are at 383. We have 36 confirmed cases yesterday, and we're just waiting for the data that will come in today. But the four facilities that I mentioned, in our experience, they have never been 100% full So there's always a daily turnover. May nadadagdag, may natatanggal. So constantly there is a turnover of patients. And if the numbers continue to rise, what we will do really is just have to utilize other facilities such as public elementary schools that are beside the hospital. In fact, this is something that we have discussed with the IATF, and they have agreed already, especially since there will be no face-to-face schooling yet in the public schools. So just in case our facilities in the hospital will not be able to handle the volume, the public schools are ready for this. In fact, the Kalinga Center, which I mentioned earlier, and the San Juan National High School Annex, these are both school facilities that we have converted into COVID-19 facilities. So we have been doing this since March. So we are ready to do this just in case. And what we've also done is for the medical frontliners working here in San Juan Medical Center, we've converted the San Juan Elementary School into living quarters for them so that they will not have to go home anymore after working in the hospital. They just simply have to walk around 1 minute to the school where they will be living in the next few weeks or months.
Okay. Now, you mentioned 383 active cases. Has the local government actually traced each and every close or direct contact of these 383 active cases?
Yes, Christian. In fact, modesty aside, Mayor Benji Magalong cited San Juan as one of the better LGUs conducting contact tracing. And one advantage that we have really is we use a lot of digital contact tracing through technology and apps. And also because our City Health Office and the San Juan Medical Center are conducting centralized tracing along with our barangay health emergency response teams, we're able to trace them. In fact, one innovation that we've done here in San Juan is we released 3,000 pesos of financial assistance to positive patients who decide to transfer to any of our four facilities. Basically, this incentive is to make them transfer to our quarantine facilities so that we can extract them from the community so that they will not infect others, including their family members. Thus, the contact tracing becomes very fast because they really cooperate in the tracing process. It's really like an investigation. You have to backtrack who they were with, where they were, and those possibly infected by them. So I believe that San Juan has been doing a good job in terms of contact tracing.
So you actually give 3,000 pesos for every positive patient just to convince that patient to go into a government quarantine facility, right?
I would rather call it to incentivize it.
Yeah, not that's really incentive.
Because a lot of them would worry about their families, no? Sasabihin nila, mawawalan kami ng trabaho, wala kami ng papagkakitaan. So these are some factors that oftentimes discourage them. But given the fact that we will help their family, in fact, while they are in our facilities, they will receive free meals, that they have free medicines, their doctors and nurses 24 hours a day, and there's even free Wi-Fi. So we incentivize this so that they will come out clean and admit that, okay, they are positive patients. We've also passed an ordinance penalizing those who do not declare that they or their family members are positive. So they are all required to declare this, because some of them are really just scared to come out and admit that they're positive. And now that we have our own mass testing facilities here, those who are close contacts of all of these positive patients are easily tested. We bought our own PCR machine way back March so that we have our own testing capacity. Okay. And as I mentioned earlier, the testing centers of the Mega Swabbing area in Palacio de Manila, where we have been assigned, have been locally transferred to us starting today. So we expect that we can do over 1,000 a day in terms of testing. We've combined the testing capacities already. Our own PCR machine, Philippine Red Cross, the testing capacities of the national government, and also private testing centers.
Okay, of course, that's one piece of good news, the incentive provided by the local government, because I know that other local government units are also experiencing certain problems in terms of convincing patients to actually be more forthright or transparent with their condition. Now, as a final point, Mayor Zamora, the national government, the Department of Health, said that during this two-week MECQ, part of the plan is actually to conduct house-to-house check, a house-to-house check to determine the symptomatic patients inside each and every household in targeted areas to be determined. Now, is this going to be implemented, for example, in San Juan, and how are you going to do that?
Yes, actually, we've been implementing the Oplan Kalinga. That's what the IATF calls it. And the 3,000 pesos that we're offering is actually in conjunction with the Oplan Kalinga, because once our barangay health emergency response teams and our barangay officials inform the city health office that there are suspect cases or indeed positive cases already, we immediately visit them and extract them from the community. And part of the negotiations really is offering them comfortable accommodations while they are quarantined, because like what I said, much of their worry comes from the fact that they will have to be separated from their families, and offering them some sort of assistance while they're away usually eases the sadness that comes along once they are required to be quarantined for 2 weeks. This means that they will be separated from their families. And Christian, if I may share also, we have also been releasing 5,000 pesos for our public medical frontliners and 3,000 pesos for public non-medical frontliners.
Okay.
This is a little show of appreciation for them. For all the effort that they've done for San Juan. And this has also lifted the morale of our frontliners, because they are very essential in all of this, because they are the ones really who trace and extract positive patients from the community.
Mm.
So this helps a lot in the overall execution of the Oplan Kalinga here in San Juan.
Okay, Mayor Francis Zamora, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, Christian.